Oh, hey. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Alright, so this is going to be kind of like a advanced, I guess, hardtail tutorial using the Fab Kevin kit. Forgive me, I mumble the entire time, so bear with me, but this is basically just how I whipped it together, and maybe it'll help some people. I don't know, check it out. So it's a 19, I think, like a 78 shovel head frame. My buddy up in Canada wants it hardtailed. So this is my frame fixture. I made out of a 60 inch bridge port table, which is pretty cool because everything can center off of this center T slot, super flat. Made these little fixtures to mount everything in. The trans one's down there, which would go back here. First thing you're gonna do, you don't have to worry about, it's just kind of bolted in there. Eventually we'll square this all up, make sure everything's straight and true. You're gonna wanna cut it right near the cast marks, right around here. And then on the top, we'll probably cut this as square as you can, right behind that weld, somewhere around here. Well, you get the idea. And probably just use a chop saw, because every time I've done it with a cutoff wheel, it blows up in my face. Stock frame ruined forever. So this is what you get with the Fab Kevin hardtail kit. Looks like John from Hardtail Choppers makes these really nice castings. I use this stuff a bunch of times, really nice. You got your two upper rails. I'm guessing that's the crossover, or the top tube connects the two top rails. And you got your two bottom rails. And once it's all welded up, it'll look like a hardtail kit. It also comes with a straight piece for your backbone part. So we're going to discard that. We'll make one that's got a nice bend in it, like a stock frame. So the next thing you're going to want to do is center these axle plates up to your fixture. I just measured halfway and made a little mark. In my fixture, I made these little blocks fit in there real snug. So once you get these plates set in here, these are the drawings that come with the, you know, measure everything. It's basically stock dimensions, the same thing you can find on like a Harley blueprint. The width of the axle, the height, the center of the axle. And then from the rear center of the rear transmission stud to the center of the axle plate, it's 16 3/4. You measure back, then 8.5 inches up from the bottom of the frame rail. You'll find a way to measure from the center of your axle plate to the rear center of the rear transmission stud, and you'll measure up from my table. The frame sits up about 2.5 inches from the bottom of the table itself. Then we'll add that, so it needs to be around 11 inches, but this plate down here is 3/4 inch, so we can just minus that off. So we know this is 8.5 inches from the bottom of the frame, and 16 3/4 inch back to the center line. And the other thing you want to check too, make sure these things are all square to each other and lined up this way. Slide a couple of rods in there. And if you use your angle finder, you can check these angles roughly. So one's supposed to be 25, sitting right at 25. There's a little play in there too, so if it's within a quarter of a degree or so, it'll be fine. And you'll check the bottom one, so pretty close. Zero your gauge out again. With the table, check your fixture and make sure it's square this way. And then you'll check this way on one of these rods. Make sure that they're in plane with each other this way, they're not tweaked. Which if these angles are off, then it means you'll check the other side too. If they're off, that's you just tweaked a little bit. Adjust it around to get it square in all planes this way, and these things should be parallel to each other across that plane. The kit comes with all these various different little slugs. When you start prepping all this stuff, a good way to measure that, this weird one, the offset cope, can be for down here. What you want to do is find a scrap piece of inch and eighth tube, kind of slide it in there so it's nice and straight. Well, also, these things are probably going to fit kind of tight. These Harley didn't use standardized tubing like we have nowadays, so it's kind of tight fit. If you have access to a lathe, you might have to spin these down, size them up so they'll fit properly. So yeah, take your scrap piece, it's nice and straight, and then I would just line this up to where I had cut them off before. Use the calipers, get a nice measurement. Then you can know, you can either scribe that mark on the edge and keep sanding that down with a flap disc until you get a, there's going to be a nice gap too, because when you're 16 to 8th of an inch gap to get your torch in there. Once that all lines up real nice, tap all this in there, it should all fit up real nice and snug. All that stuff. Good thing to do is just kind of sand these down, use a little square, try to get them as square as you can. I always drill every one with a probably like a 5/16 hole, and since this slug goes in there, you can make yourself a nice rosette weld to hold this in there. And then you want to go through before you start pounding all these in. If they're kind of tight, sometimes you're gonna have to pound them all in there. Make sure you clear all the paint off. Get yourself a nice bevel for your weld bead. Deburr the inside. You might have to use like a sander. Go in there, sand them out and clean them out. So this is kind of what you're going for when you get it all fit up. Bevel, nice bevel edge, a little bit of a gap so you can get your torch down in there and grab the bung and the pipe together. Make a nice bead and a real nice flush fit here. You'll find too, when these, you cut these old frames apart, all this was all connected at once, so sometimes this stuff spring, these will spring apart. So always check that too, because this side is actually bent out that way. So I'm going to have to use a C-clamp and pull it back over straight. I just use like the side of my fixture for measuring. Set of calipers and stack something up that's flat. Make sure this distance is the same as this side so they're square with the table. So when you go to size these bend parts up,
make sure you have your bends going the right way. But what I did is measure from the seat post tube back. It's like 7.5 inches or so. Make sure that distance is the same on this side. That way when you go to trim this up, the bends will be in the same spot. And then an important thing that I almost screwed up here is when you're measuring this, only cut material off this end, not this end. Because if you cut off this side, it'll end up being too short when you cut this. This moves forward and lines it right up. So I just stuck one piece in there, slid it on the slug, and then the extra that was hanging off the back, just measured from the bottom of the casting to the tip, and marked it on this end, and always cut a little long, that way you can kind of size this up if you need it. And make sure you take this whole casting off and slide it in there when you check it, because it'll look like it's not going to fit, but it actually does fit, so you'll have to slide it in there and then just keep sanding it down until you get a nice gap in there. Here's another example where that sometimes these spring apart when you cut them apart. You can see that's how much that thing moved over. So I'll just measure from this to the outside of my table, because I know this is centered to the backbone of the table. So you want to have that line back up according to the factory specs. So I'm just going to use a C-clamp and push it back over, tack it, bolt that fifth trans mount down so it stays where it's at until I can weld it all back up. At this, when you're sizing this up, this is where it looks kind of deceiving, like you need to cut more off. This is actually pretty close now, so we take this back off. Slide that back in there. When I line that back up, it's actually a pretty good fit. Just need to take off a little bit more so we can get a nice gap down in here. This is what you're going for when you get it final sized up. I don't know if you can see the hash marker, but center your axle plate back up. Drill out some plug holes or rosette welds, whatever you want to call them, on both sides for the slug. And then nice little chamfers and get a nice fat bead in there. Lock the axle in. Then put a little chamfer on these bungs too, so you can get a nice penetration in there. You want to have that little 1/8 inch gap or so you can get your torch in there to, you know, weld to the slug and the pipe and fill the slug holes in to keep it all locked in.
So when you go to fit this top tube, this is the point you're going to have to make an executive decision, because this angle is 25 degrees. This one's slightly more. I forget what it is exactly. 17 and a half or something like that. So you could cheat like most people do, and they'll just put this in here and the bend kind of goes up here instead of being real nice straight. And you also kind of will have it's going to have a big gap. You could force it in there, but right thing to do be this. You could do it this way. As you can see, it's got the nice straight line back like it's supposed to. They did that. Seems kind of crazy, but once it's finished, you'll see. I just cut the casting directly in half. And that way you can heat this tube up and then pull that all back down. We'll pull that twist back out of it so it'll stay really straight.
And I'll come back through here and probably just bevel this out a little bit, fill that in with MIG weld on both sides, and then grind it all back smooth. So it'll, to the untrained eye, it would just look like it never happened. And plus the seat's gonna go over that and stuff too, so I'll try to make it look like it never happened, but really it doesn't matter, just fill it back in. That'd be the better way than cheating, because if you look, we'll compare it to a real pan head frame. It's a slight droop down right here. And if you look at a real pan head frame, this is my friend's 48 pan frame, and like we're saying, that the stock frame has that nice line that comes down. But if you look too, that little droop's there on the factory frame too. So it kind of looks more stock that way anyways. Okay, so that's just the way that I decided to make that look right. You can figure out how you want to do it. That's kind of like how a stock, make it look more like a pan head frame, but maybe other ways to do it. You probably get more creative than I can, but we go to set up this cut for these top tubes. Just kind of lay it in there. Make sure you get your ends squared off the same distance from like that weld roughly on both sides. And then just make your mark right here. Cut a little bit long. It's always better to go long than too short. And start trimming that back until you get a real nice fit. And the same deal, test fit it by taking the whole casting off, and you'll want to slide the bottom one on first. This one, they'll all kind of slide together and slide in there real nice. After you correct that bend, it'll lay right back up to your fixture too, which is nice. So once you get one of those top rails sized up, it should be exactly the same. Just kind of double check where the bends line up on something real flat. Use some other thing flat to kind of line them all up. Since they should be exactly the same, just come through and put your mark right there and cut it a little extra just in case. It should come out to the right size when you put it up on the other side. This point, you should start looking like a motorcycle frame. Look pretty good.